Did you know that 21 cities in India will run out of groundwater by 2020, according to Niti Aayog? Hi, I'm Neha, and welcome to Logically India's YouTube channel. The water crisis in Chennai has been hitting headlines like never before, and the fear that such crisis can happen in several other cities is also rising. India's worst ever water crisis might now cripple the twin cities of Hyderabad and Secunderabad in the next 48 days. Chennai has been facing a severe water crisis for more than a month now, and there has been a 40% cut in piped water supply after all four reservoirs outside the city dried up. One perspective states that while inappropriate planning of land usage, coupled with the lack of measures for the conservation and management of water resources, can be blamed for the current scenario, changes in rainfall patterns also had its share of impacts. From extreme rainfall events to no rain for over 190 days, Chennai has been swung between floods and drought. But to even consider surviving the climate emergency underway, India needs more than mega projects. It needs the collective power of abundant, small-scale, nature-based efforts to seize the seasonal bounty across the diverse landscape of South Asia. Another perspective states that while irregular rainfall is a major cause of concern, scientific advancements in climatology and weather systems that predict a weak monsoon or extreme rainfall event is still a challenge. With such uncertainties, managing reservoirs does become difficult. India is urbanizing at a rapid pace, and amid the human density lies an opportunity. Development of watersheds, improving storage of surface water, recharging groundwater, and mitigating floods through stormwater drains are only some measures. Before we move on to an expert's opinion on this topic, here's what a few of you had to say.
Yes.
Not anytime soon, maybe. In my opinion, maybe 8-10 years at the least that Pune faces a water crisis, basically.
Yes, it will.
Yes, of course, we are already facing water crisis.
Because most people can afford to order water tankers, and where, like, it's not a middle-class society, even if it's like, you know, smaller societies or slums, then the government provides water tankers. So in cities, you don't feel it. There definitely must be a water crisis because even a lot of the dams are not up to capacity. So you do start getting water cuts pretty soon, like even after the rains finish, you start getting water cuts very soon. But yeah, because you can order water tankers, you don't really feel it.
Yes, I have basics, saving water at the ground level, basically putting off taps, getting rid of leakages wherever. There are these things which are called aerators, which have been installed in all the taps that we have at home and most of the taps at work. So those are the efforts that we are putting in at a basic level to try and save whatever little bit of water that we can in our scopes.
Yeah, we are doing, but unfortunately, like, one person cannot do. Like, we need our country to do it together, and it will work out.
Yes, not many things. Like restricting wherever leakages are there, we are trying to change our taps. I am into hospitality business, so we have used modern techniques in our business also to reduce the water consumption.
Personal level, first things, though, we have educated ourselves, our kids, people around us on the necessity to save water, right? At home, we conserve water as much as possible. We don't throw away half glasses of water. Whatever water I use to wash my vegetables every day, that is the water I use to plant, you know, water my plants every day, be it any time of the day. I don't make a fixed rule that I have to water them at 8 in the morning. If I'm washing my vegetables at 11 in the morning, I water them at 11. So I keep that water and use it. So these are little small steps that we use to conserve water at our personal level.
So at a personal level, mostly what you can do is, like, as a guy, like, if you are, when you're taking a bath, you try not to take a bath with a shower. Because you can, like, a shower wastes a lot of water, so you basically fill up a bucket and you bathe with that. Or when you're shaving, then you also, you know, you don't keep the water running, or you just take some water in a mug and you shave with that. So that's what you can do at, you know, individual levels to save water.
I
I personally haven't gone so deep into thought, but I personally feel large scale water conservation would come in with a little bit of education to the people of knowing the importance, and especially entering the rural areas and giving them a little more knowledge about the importance of water and the reserves left and the crisis our country is about to face in terms of water. So taking care of that at that level is where I think we should start off at.
The main and the most thing that we need to educate people about is that water is precious. It is no longer previous times where water was in abundance, yet today it is a crisis. There are many floods and everything. We could do rainwater harvesting to increase the amount of water in the planet, but still, it's still gonna go down if you keep wasting it. You have so many water trucks going on the streets of India where the taps are open, everything is falling out. And you have so many people who just waste water, playing holy and other things. It wastes water. So if you could just just think a little bit, conserve water and a little bit more, I feel like the whole world would be much better. We would not have a water crisis ever again.
Lot of many things can be done. Like, you know, water wastage, specifically in India, like if you compare it with Israel is a already water short country, but now they are having surplus water and have been supplying it to other countries. That is only possible with proper discipline. And what I feel is people who live in India should concentrate on their own personal wastages and try to avoid those.
I think we can go back to our traditional ways of saving water. One of them being this rainwater harvesting, which we've successfully implemented in our society. For the last 10 years, we are tanker free because of it. Then there are lots of, you know, small lakes and poddies and all those that used to be there earlier. We can rebuild them. I think pura rainwater harvesting, if you can't do, at least, you know, you can just dig up in barren lands, dig up something and leave it. Something will seep in at least. And maybe, you know, increase the green cover so that you have more rain. And concretization jo ho rahi hai, concrete sab jagah everywhere, there's no place left for water to seep in. So that I think should be done at government level, at a higher level than individual.
Well, one of the things that has to be done is you have to figure out, or you have to implement ways to recharge your groundwater. The second, I think, tree plantation also has to be done at massive levels, because that's one of the reasons why the water no longer sort of stops anywhere, right? So you have concretization and you have a lot of a lot of the green areas are going away. So because of that, you're not getting water as, like, the water doesn't seep down. So I think that is, those are two things that should definitely be done.
So
they say that the next war is going to be over water. Can't really be sure as to how soon that would happen. Hopefully it won't happen, but I guess with the way the things are going, if I'm not wrong, South Africa did a no water day as well. Because anyway, so bottom line being, I guess it's not very far off. Maybe 8-10 years, at least the politics around water is going to start very soon. So that being said, yeah,
almost the water war is started.
It will be very soon, considering what's going on today. In today's planet, more than 40 countries across the world are suffering from water crises. So obviously we're going to have a water war in the next few years, I'd say. I'm not going to give it 20 years. I'm going to say in the next 5 to 6 years, we're going to have a water war.
The alarm bells are already ringing. We are already in a state of crisis. It won't be very long when we'll be out of water, probably drinking or, you know, even consumption for personal use. That water will be soon off of the planet completely.
Very soon, I think, very soon. I remember 20 years back when I got married, my father-in-law used to say ki third world war will be on water. And now I tell him ki Papa, you were so right. Another, I think, 5 to 10 years we'll see a world war on water. If we don't, you know, it's like my sister says, we in a final warning de raha environment. Ab nahi chete to gaye.
Actually, so this is slightly tangential, but one of them actually happened, because the war in Syria, which is sort of still going on, one of the causes of it was a massive drought that happened around the 2011-2012 period, and because of which a lot of the farming community in Syria started to move into cities, and that started causing shortages in cities and everything. So you already have instances where you can't directly say, because then that led to like political issues. But, and so you can't directly say that water was an issue, but it was one of the initial issues. So you're already seeing places in the world where water is causing problems. And that will definitely escalate over time. Like, you will definitely have issues happening as things get more and more worse.
And this brings us to Colonel Shashikant Dalvi, the man propagating water conservation, storage, harvesting, and more for years now. 72-year-old Colonel Dalvi has been working relentlessly to solve water crisis in the country. He has spent 16 years of his life educating and initiating rainwater harvesting systems across his city in Pune. In 2002, he bought a flat in a housing complex in Vimannagar, where to satisfy the needs of 57 flats, they had to get 3 big tankers of water, costing them 25,000 rupees per month. This promoted him to start a rainwater harvesting consultancy, and within a year, the society was completely tanker-free. So let's welcome Colonel Shashikant Dalvi. So Colonel, since you have this background of being in the environment and being a water, being into water conservation, how severe do you think are the water crises in India currently or over the world?
Yeah, it is. It is a very important question, because last few years we all are facing the water crisis. Even though we may say that we should use only 150 liters per day per person, our usage is way beyond 300 liters per day per person. Water is a finite quantity as far as fresh water is concerned. 75% of our planet Earth's surface is covered by 97% of the water. So balance of 1% water has protected all the flora found on this planet. But today, it is not so. Because of the rising global warming, adding to our big demands, various factors are there. The rainfall is decreasing. Percolation rate is increasing, percolation decreasing because of the urbanization. There are shifts in the monsoon cycle because of, again, global warming. So all these factors will add to the water crisis.
So earlier when I was talking to you, Colonel, you mentioned about the different countries in the world, of how Cape Town has water scarcity. Even India, actually, Bangalore and Chennai are running out of water. Even Niti Aayog announced that 21 cities in India are completely going to be running out of groundwater. So what do you have to say about this?
Very true, because, you know, like I mentioned earlier, that we are doing unsustainable over-extraction of the groundwater. World over, people are telling the Indian government that we are withdrawing 25% of the groundwater, whereas China and US together, they are withdrawing only 18%. As the urbanization started, the percolation rate has reduced from almost 35% to as low as 5% or 7%. In the cities also, we depend still, almost about 60% of our water supply depends on the groundwater. So if we are not going to recharge the groundwater table, what Nitya says is a fairly big, severe warning to us. This crisis will become very, very severe.
So in one of your articles, Colonel, you spoke about the distinction between availability of water and conservation of water. Could you shed some light on it?
Yeah, very good question, Neha. We always consider the dam water, reservoir water as a main source of supply. But that should not be the only criteria. You know, Mother Earth gives you water, that is rainwater, where you stay, wherever you stay. Like Bombay is having 2,500 millimeters of rainfall, whereas Pune is having 750 millimeters of annual average rainfall. If you convert it into potentiality, in 1,000 square feet of a rooftop area, in Bombay, you receive almost 2.5 lakh liters of water per year.
Wow.
Imagine how much water this water is not included into water supply management program. So this is the availability.
So just to give the audience a glimpse about expectations versus reality, what are we actually supposed to do, what is expected of us to do to conserve water, versus what we are actually doing in reality? Could you shed some light on it?
The water comes in three, you know, parts. One is white water, which is supplied to us. It is clean water, fresh, clean, safe and drinking water. That water, once we use it, it gets converted into grey and black water. Black water is water coming out of our cupboards. Now, we are only depending upon our tap water. So, what we as a common man can use that water for your benefit to recharge groundwater. So, similarly, you can use the grey water, recycle it, reuse it for your flushing, for your gardening, etc. So, you can definitely conserve the every drop of water supplied to you. Majority of us are not doing rainwater harvesting, and majority of us also are not doing the grey water recycling and reuse. Maybe the lack of awareness, maybe lack of implementation of the rules and regulations by the local body governments.
Absolutely.
There are a number of things definitely, but we are definitely not following. They are individually doable things. We'll be heading for a trouble.
So this entire target of completely eradicating water scarcity, is it achievable or is it overambitious?
It is achievable, like you said. It is definitely achievable, provided individually and collectively and community-wise, if we decide to work on it, we can definitely achieve this or eradicate this particular water crisis.
Absolutely.
It is definitely achievable, provided all the stakeholders, including government, contribute to its success.
Now that you've mentioned government, do you think water is going to be a vote bank in the upcoming elections?
It will be. If you clearly observe the states where they are going to election in the next 6 months or 8 months, you'll find the more emphasis by the state governments is given, giving on the groundwater recharge, how to provide waters to farmers, cities, use of rainwater harvesting, water conservation. Only thing is here also what is lacking is, you know, you want everybody to do rainwater harvesting. You want everybody to do water conservation, groundwater recharge. You launch something, but then you must have a infrastructure ready to receive it.
Do you think eradicating water scarcity is an achievable target? Don't forget to let us know in the comment section below. That's all for today. Thanks for watching Logically India's YouTube channel. If you want better news analysis and more fact checkers, don't forget to download the Logically app. The link is in the description below. Like, subscribe, and remember, when you think news, always think logically.